You see right here the 26. Off turn four. Okay, gets very, very loose. Just really spins out. Loses control. Probably had very little side force. Too wide. Sideways. Now it's quite smoked. No one can see. The 48 of Stenhouse. The 27 sees it. He goes as far left as he can. He has a choice. Am I even going to hit the inner pit wall or stay on the racetrack? And he just launches off the 48 upside down. And then this long slide had to feel like forever. I'm not going to know what's better, sliding or tumbling. I'm going to say sliding if he's fine, but you know, watch how close Jeb was to the end of this pit wall. He has a split decision, pit road or not. The yellow barrels are not a good option.
Yeah, he made the right decision not to try to turn left there at the last moment. Just a no-win situation for Jeb.
And the spotter coming on, asking him if he's okay, and also telling him no one's going to hit you. That would be the other thing that a driver would fear, is he's in such a vulnerable position.
So now the spin, look at all the smoke. So you want to say, all right, here's where I want to go, but you're just trying to miss him. And then it happens that quick. I mean, that decision has to be made in milliseconds.
That's why, Kierba, I love slow motion replay shows us the violence. Like, this will show just how much that car launches in the air. Now, look at this hit right here. He lands basically on the driver's side door, tumbles onto the A-post. That shows how violent it is, but there's nothing like a full-speed replay to show you Jeb's decision-making. It is right now, left or right.